Why does God need our worship? It doesn't. We need to worship Him. That's a natural thing. Of course, on a higher level, you may say he does, but when we're talking in the realms of bhava, love, then it's different. But otherwise, God is completely surat, independent, he's atmarama, he's completely satisfied in himself. He doesn't need anything. What there's nothing lacking in God, because everything is his. He's the controller of everything, he's the maintainer of everything, and he's the destroyer of everything, either directly or indirectly. So there's no impediment to him. Whatever wants to do, he can do. And nothing can restrict that activity. So he's not in need of anything. That he comes in here and gives us a process how to correct our mentality. Because our mentality in the material world, we left the spiritual world, in the material world, we're trying to imitate God, right? Everyone wants to control the situation. Everyone wants to be on top of their particular field. And everyone wants to enjoy the situation. But we're always endeavoring for this, but God doesn't have to endeavor for it, because he is the controller, he is the owner, proprietor, and he is the enjoyer. So he doesn't need anything, but he, out of his kindness, he's coming to give us service to him. So this is the correct use of the material energy if we engage it in his service. This way it becomes purified. And then we're reinstated in our original constitution as the eternal servants of Krishna. And then we'll be fully satisfied.